In your money matters this morning, Wells Fargo taking aim at Chase with a new rewards credit card, and Amazon had a rough start to Prime Day. Bobby Rebell at the NASDAQ with those stories. Good morning, Bobby.
Good morning. Well, Wells Fargo has released a new rewards card in partnership with American Express. So the card is going to have no annual fee and is meant, as you said, to compete with the Chase Sapphire card. The new Propel card will offer 3x points per dollar spent on the same categories as that card, specifically dining, including restaurants and bars, and travel, which includes bars and restaurant delivery services. All right, tax cuts helped Bank of America have its most profitable start in history. The bank also benefited from a jump in lending and from its continued move to cut costs. Bank of America also says mobile deposits surpassed those in person. Amazon's site crashed late Monday afternoon, as you alluded to, interrupting the flow of sales during the e-commerce giant's 2018 Prime Day. Millions of dollars in sales could potentially have been lost during the outage. Now, according to downdetector.com, that's a website that tracks outages, Amazon's Alexa Prime Video services and Amazon Web Services also were experiencing outages. New emojis are coming soon for iPhone users. Apple says the emojis are on the way, including someone giving puppy dog eyes, a bald woman and a man, and also a male and female superheroes. The new emojis are going to be out in the fall. All right, on August 1st, Southwest is going to be switching to pretzels after dropping peanuts last week because of allergic reactions. The Washington Post says on longer flights, the airline is going to be offering a rotating menu of small bites, including wheat thins, veggie chips, and cinnamon Nabisco plain cookies. Maybe pancakes soon one day after this story. IHOP is back to focusing on pancakes, and today they're going to have a special promotion to celebrate that and its birthday from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. on Tuesday at participating IHOP restaurants nationwide. You can get 3 buttermilk pancakes for 60 cents. The S&P 500 lost ground as oil prices fell on worries Russia would increase output beyond what it agreed to last month. The NASDAQ was also down while the Dow rose 45 points. Looking at the pre-market action today, it looks like it's going to be relatively flat at the open. In terms of the Dow, it's showing a slightly positive indication. The NASDAQ, though, weaker because of a Netflix report. Their earnings fell short of expectations, so weakness in the tech sector expected. Live from the NASDAQ market site in Times Square, I'm Bobby Rebell for Fox 8 News. Back to you.
Bobby, thanks so much.
All right, coming up.